nutrition. So in this chapter, we have learned about photosynthesis, isn't it? So photosynthesis is the process where plants prepare their own food materials, isn't it? Not only they prepare the food materials for themselves, but all the organisms which are existing here on the surface of the earth. Then we also learned about the mechanism of photosynthesis. Then photosynthesis is the only process which releases oxygen into the atmosphere, and it's the only process which utilizes the carbon dioxide which is present in the atmosphere. Then in the same unit, we also learned about the human digestive system. So what is digestion? So digestion is a process where the complex food particles are broken down to simple molecules. But during the process of digestion, is the energy released? No, energy is not released. So during the process of digestion, only the food particles are broken down to simple molecules. Then in second unit, you have learned about respiration, isn't it? So in this lesson, you must have learned about the structure of lungs, working of the lungs, respiration in plants, isn't it? Then you have seen the gases, how it occurs in the lungs. Then what is respiration here? Respiration is oxidation of food materials.
So among all these
ammonia is the most common substance which is present in our body. Okay, so there are waste materials which are present in our body are carbon dioxide, water, the nitrogenous compounds like urea, uric acid, ammonia, salts, and also biopigments. So among all these, ammonia is the most toxic substance which is present in the body. Okay, then next, what is metabolism? So anabolism and catabolism together collectively called as the metabolism. Then what is catabolism? Breaking down of a molecule. Breaking down of a molecule is called as catabolism. Example, respiration. Yes, so anabolism and catabolism together are collectively called as a metabolism. So any new molecules are synthesized in our body is called as the anabolism. Example is photosynthesis. Then breaking down of a molecule is called as the catabolism. Example, it is respiration, isn't it? Then in your textbook on page number 74, they have given a small table, isn't it? So here they are asking you to write what are the products of these different life processes. Okay, so page number 74, they are asking you to complete the table. So first life process is photosynthesis. So the products of this photosynthesis are oxygen plus water. Then next, respiration. This is carbon dioxide and water. Then next, digestion. It is glucose, amino acids, fatty acids and glycerol. Next we start with the human excretory system. Pair of kidneys, pair of ureters, ureter bladder, urethra. So in order to study the detailed structure of the kidneys, now we shall learn about a lab activity. Okay. Materials required. Materials required here are, firstly you have to collect a specimen of goat or sheep kidney, isn't it? So here we are learning about the human excretion, then you will be getting a doubt. As we are learning about the human excretion, we need to collect a human kidney. But here I have written specimen of goat or sheep kidney, you have to collect it from a butcher, isn't it? So, as the human kidney is not easily available, isn't it? That's the reason we are going to collect the goat or sheep kidney from a butcher. So as a structure and functions of the kidney is similar to the humans. Okay, next. Brain, water, scalpel, then sharp blade. Next, procedures. So firstly, whenever you collect the specimen from the butcher, so neatly you have to put it under the running tap water and neatly you have to leave it so that the blood is completely drained out. And when the blood is completely removed, then you have to put it in the tray. Then you have to observe for the external features of the kidney. Okay, so your observation is you have to note down the external features of the kidney in your notebook. So about the external features of the kidney, I am going to tell you in the next class. Okay, then when once you complete taking down the points regarding the external features of the kidney, then we have to go for the LS of the kidney. Got it? Yes. So this is the kidney, isn't it? So in this way, that is longitudinal section of the kidney, you are going to cut it. Then after, you are also going to note down the internal structure of the kidney. Got it?